striking of Joshua Pasio. Pasio, the former world champion. Saruta, the one world champion, and Shuto, world champion. Take there from Saruta. Switch his stance between the knocks itself through here.
That's the low leg kicks of Joshua Pasio. He says he wants to attack that lower part of the leg and start kicking the calf of Saruta.
Now, Mitch, Saruta isn't using that awkward, strange 90-degree angle guard we saw him use last time. Oh, turn it back kick! Smack back in the guts from Joshua Pasio.
Nice spinning back kick from Joshua Pasio. You're right, Michael, he's not utilizing that guard, but again, that's more the mind games coming from the ninja. Doesn't want to utilize that guard, but I do think we'll see it later on in this matchup.
Overhand right from Saruta, outside leg kick, overhand right again there from Saruta. Chance went up for Let's Go Pasio. Here's Miller.
Nice duck under to a double leg from Saruta as he ends up in half guard.
Pasio, see the instructions from Mark Sanjau in the corner here from Team Legai. Half guard position for the champion. Vicious ground and pound that he had. Patience here from Pasio, a stalemate move.
You can see Saruta's got his head wrapped around, or his arm, his left arm wrapped around the neck there. He can try to get past his half guard position of Joshua Pasio. There's a choke he's got as long as Joshua Pasio holds the head in that position.
Look for finish.
Under 3 minutes remaining, first round set for five for the strawweight world title. Referee Kim Ching right on top of the action. If Pasio can win the title back, the wall of Asia Arena will melt down. To their feet, inside leg kick here from the champion Saruta. Oh, the high kick! Tried for the headache maker. Did Joshua Pasio.
Joshua Pasio's going headhunting early. He's already tried to go upstairs a couple of times now.
Big hello to all our fans watching on ABS-CBN Sports in Action here in the Philippines on Abima TV in Japan. Skips forward the champion, doesn't commit though. There's a left hand from Saruta. Definitely inside the middle of Asia Arena when they chant Pasio's name. All of Team Legai's former champions are here. Flying Balignon, Eustaquio. Also in attendance, circle side, the world's heavyweight champion, Philippine star Brandon Vera. So many luminaries have turned out in force for this night of nights in Filipino martial arts. The balls of his feet again here, Saruta. Inside leg kick from the champion. Still, Mitch, a filling out process from both of these two competitors.
You know, they're still kind of just, you know, there's not a lot of...
Oh, big smack bang! The big kibosh from Saruta. And Pasio on the canvas, on his back now.
That's the end of the filling out process, I assume.
Saruta's got some confidence flowing now. He tries to mount it.
Pasio's got to keep him tight to get his grip back about it. This is where Saruta's got to create a little bit of space. I'd like to see him frame off the head and start pushing the head down. There he goes. Good scramble by Joshua.
Pasio back to his feet. The crowd appreciates that. Let's see the Russian starting now with Pasio. And he beat the champion to the strikes.
The first match happened about 13 weeks ago, so that's not a lot of time to make a lot of improvement. But what you can do is you can get in better shape and also figure out your game plan. Whoever can implement their game plan. Perfection tonight is going to be the one who walks with that belt.
Looping punches from Pasio. 20 seconds remains. Low check there from Saruta. And Saruta taunting in the mind games from the Japanese world champion.
Taunting with the right hand there. Is that what he's doing?
Trying to get inside the head of Pasio. Pasio jumping roundhouse kick off the lead leg. That's going to be a Filipino victory. Good two-punch combination off the bell there for Pasio. Switching stance, Saruta. AEG veteran. Has all the tricks in the book, and then some that aren't even written in the book. Marcio looks to get airborne with that knee, but didn't commit to it, didn't have the distancing.
That's good.
Saruta inside leg kick. High kick from Pascio. He's enjoying that high right roundhouse tonight. Hasn't really found success with it, though.
He was expecting to throw that roundhouse kick off of the awkward guard shown by Saruta, and Saruta hasn't shown him that guard yet. Again, more of that veteran mind game move as Pascio.
Spinning back fist from Saruta. Okay. Counter punch. Okay. Pascio accidentally struck the back of the head. Apologies there. Good sportsmanship. The media attention on this bout, on this entire card, has been crazy. Our media conference at City of Dreams earlier on in the week was a record attendance, some 500 plus media members, the biggest in history. All over the news, and Team Lakai athletes appearing on CNN Philippines earlier this week. Outside leg kick there from Saruta. Manila really is a hotbed for one championship. Indeed, this entire combat crazy nation love one championship, especially when it comes to town. It was in Saruta's town a couple of weeks ago in Tokyo. And Falaya saw the title lost against Shinya Aoki, who put him to sleep in the first round. Meaning that all of Team Lakai's titles were gone. It's now the responsibility of Papascio to win one back for the men from Baguio City.
Good movement shown by Saruta, but as soon as Saruta stopped and got a stationary stance, that's when Papascio spun and landed another spinning back kick. I think this movement's kind of got Joshua Papascio a little bit confused here in the second as he marches forward and throws a big right hand there from Saruta.
Haven't really seen Pascio open up with his wushu, with the striking, the combinations. Has had some acrobatics, turning back kicks and jumping roundhouse kicks. Nothing that's landed effective telling blows absolutely so far. Another agonizingly close rear leg roundhouse kick. Left hand followed by a right there by Saruta.
Saruta closes that distance incredibly fast with that lightning fast footwork, how he's in and out of there. And Pascio seems to have a hard time getting into the rhythm.
Lots of angles being cut here from Saruta.
Like that strategy employed by Saruta, not to stay still as he ducks under a big head kick there.
Certainly, Pascio is going for that head kick time and time again. There's the first show of that strange forearm guard that Saruta did last time that confounded Pascio. Oh, overhand right from Saruta, tried for the counter.
Pascio said he didn't want to spin as much as he did in the first time, because you can start to see that Saruta started to time that, started to step to the outside right as Pascio was spinning. And that's the same mistake that Foliang made with Nguyen. Nguyen saw it coming over and over again, and he started to step to the side. And then what happened? Boom, a big overhand right that caught Foliang mid-spin. Pascio's got to be careful with this spinning. You can see
when leg kick there from Saruta. Mitch went high on the thigh, but do you think that both men are holding back a little here? We haven't really seen them put the foot down.
Well, in the second round, they're still trying to get a bearing on each other. I don't think Pascio expected Saruta to A, come out in this stance, be this mobile. And I think the Saruta is a little bit surprised at the inactivity coming back from Pascio, because Pascio said he did not want to wait. He did not want to hesitate. Last 10 seconds.
Of a break off there from Saruta. Final few seconds of this round. High kick from Pascio. Two rounds down. Roundhouse kick from Pascio, just tucked under the left arm. Thrust out the jab with the Filipino. Body shot, stuck it well, belly button through the back.
Masha likes that technique. He likes to go high with the roundhouse and then follow it up with a spinning back kick. He was able to drop Roy Deliguez back in 2017 in the second round with a beautiful spinning back fist off of that roundhouse kick.
Let's see if Pacquiao can work those wushu kicking skills of his. Lots of movement here from Yasuke Tsuruta. Tsuruta, the current world champion, Pacquiao, the former world champion. And right there from Pacquiao.
Tsuruta is still the owner of the biggest punch so far in this match with that big overhand right that happened in the first. Nice leg kick there by Pacquiao.
Good punch combination from Pacquiao. Backs off Tsuruta.
You can start to see the superficial damage on the lower lead leg of Pacquiao starting to welt up there from that one kick. There's Tsuruta mixing things in with the takedowns. Skip the takedown. Now he's trying to pass the guard. Elevation there from Pacquiao to get back to his feet.
The crowd momentarily thought that Pacquiao had a choke locked onto the champion.
But I like the strategy from Tsuruta. Mix in the takedowns. Get Pacquiao thinking about that. At least start fearing it so he doesn't start to throw. So he doesn't get so comfortable with the stand-up.
Pacquiao fainting. So too Tsuruta. Razor thin, this world title matchup at the moment. Angles again from Tsuruta, the cagey one. Pacquiao tried to counter. Inside leg from Tsuruta. Good jab, no right hand for company though. Team back in, looking for the liver of Tsuruta. It's a Team Lakai specialty. The impact, the liver,
final warning.
Very large target. Just to the right of the stomach there. The impact of vagus nerve that can close down the entire body. They say one of the most painful ways, if not the most painful way to get knocked out, is with a liver strike. Particularly a liver punch where you're driving the knuckles up in between the ninth and tenth ribs. Be turning back into the liver will do just as well. Overhand right to cranium cracker there from Pacquiao. Just needed a little bit more mustard behind it. Outside leg kick. Now Pacquiao starting to land some heavier strikes, Dragon.
He is. He's starting to put together those kicks with a little bit more of the punches as well. He's throwing combinations. He's getting a little more comfortable.
Turning
spinning
back
though. That time Tsuruta was able to step to the side of it. He's starting to see it coming. Because the problem is when he steps to the side, he's able to avoid it. But when he goes back, he tries to ride the wave of that kick to it to kind of take away some of the pressure from it. I don't think it's hurting him so much, but it's scoring in the mind of the judges. And also the score sheets.
1:15 remains. Don't forget we are scoring an overall bout, not round by round, under these one championship global rule sets. High kick again from Pacquiao. Tsuruta leans back in evasion. Left hook from the champion.
That's in the third round.
Joy for the crowd as Pacquiao again bound up and spun on Tsuruta. You expect a little bit more action from Tsuruta.
I did, especially in this third round. He started the first round off very effectively, and then he's kind of gotten slowed down as the matches went on. But Pacquiao is not really doing as much as I thought he would do either. He's landed a few beautiful side kicks, and that's really been the most significant strike of this round. I do like the takedown that Tsuruta has been.
Overhand right there from Pacquiao. Inside leg goes Tsuruta. Final seconds of a third of five. Two more. Let's see if we have some more pepper. Some more on. Get up and go here. Tsuruta body punches here from Pacquiao. Tsuruta turns him around against the fence and drives the corking knees into the thighs. Pacquiao turns the champion.
Tsuruta place, and the hand there on the knee to stop any retaliation from the knees from Pacquiao.
Running shot from Pacquiao, got in quick, got out even quicker. High kick from Cerruja. Pacquiao stamp himself in center circle here. Cross up the jab. Cerruja does have some damage under the right eye, courtesy of that lead hand of Pacquiao. Some reddening on the lead thigh and shin calf area of Pacquiao, courtesy of the leg kicks from the champion. There's another one. Fourth round of five. Jab to Pacquiao. Again, Mitch gets in quick and spears, gets out.
This is the Pacquiao we expected to see. We see those fast blitzes, bop, bop, in and out. So we're just kind of getting hypnotized by it. Now he's starting to come forward.
Mitch, if the match was stopped right now, who would you have ahead?
And after the first round with the knockdown, beautiful kick there from Cerruja. Landed on Cerruja. That big first round knockdown. But now I'm starting to see in the second, third round, Pacquiao starting to inch forward. I think he's more aggressive. I think his striking superiority is there.
And a hand-wide counter from Pacquiao. Really nice left hook. Cerruja, under 3 minutes remains. Penultimate round of action here. Certainly seeing some heavier artillery being launched now by both of these world champions.
In the first match, we did not see Cerruja do a kickboxing match with Joshua Pacquiao. He was going for takedowns. He was mixing things up. He was inside the clinch, wearing on Pacquiao. Now all he's doing now is just striking with him in the last couple rounds. But to answer your question, if the match was stopped right now, I might give a slight edge to the Team Lacai athlete.
Oh, come on! That freaking Irene! Manila goes into a meltdown!
Wow! What a head kick! Kansas Saluda! And drops the champion! Strawweight world champion, the passion getting Team Lacai back into the championship realm.
He planted it like a tree. Yusuke Cerruja still on the astral plane. Joshua Pacquiao is the new champion of the world. They're going crazy here in Manila.
Wow, are we gonna see a rubber match or is that all she wrote? What a shot! Look at this head kick. I think that reminds me of the Edward Kelly against Bob Mounds, like knee slash head kick, just starching. Beautiful head kick, the walk off KO. For the passion, Joshua Pacquiao.
Let's go talk to the new champion.
Amazing scenes here in Manila. My word, a highlight reel KO. Here's Dom Lap.
To present the belt for this match, we have CEO and President Philippines of Holcim, Mr. John Stowe. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Cheng, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 43 seconds in the fourth round for your winner by way of knockout! And new one strawweight world champion, Joshua Pacquiao!
Joshua Pacquiao is once again a world champion.